Welcome to the HP Palmtop Tube channel. Today I'm going to do a quick review of Eye of the Beholder 1, an MS-DOS game developed by Westwood Associates and released by Strategic Simulations Incorporated in 1991. Now this game was available for various platforms including the Amiga, the Sega CD and others. And it was part of a series. There is a second and a third part, but unfortunately those don't work on the LX because they require VGA graphics. So to start the game, we simply start it up. We choose CGA graphics. Unfortunately, there is no support for any parallel port sound cards, and none of the patchers currently work for it. So we're just going to have to do with speaker sound for today. And I'm going to use a mouse connected via RS-232. If you'd like to know how to hook up a mouse to your HP 100 or 200LX Palmtop, please watch my upcoming video on how to connect mice to the HP DOS Palmtops for more information. So let's just watch the introduction of the game and then we'll get right into it. So the plot is set in Waterdeep. We, the lords of Waterdeep, have gathered to purge the city of an ancient evil. And now we have our four heroes who walk into the city. Well, they're not heroes yet, they're adventurers. And they present themselves before the king. So they're commissioned to find and destroy this ancient evil. And now we're preparing for our journey. So we start our search below the city in the dungeons, or in this case, to arrive at the dungeons, we have to start in the sewers. And of course, as soon as we step into the sewers, an earthquake happens and the entrance behind us is blocked off by boulders. So we are stuck in the sewers. Okay, so let's start the game. I'm gonna create a new party. Now, this could take a while, so I'm just gonna try and do it as quickly as possible because we have to create all four characters. So the first one, I'm going to select a human male. And I'm just gonna use a fighter and a lawful good. And I'm gonna choose a portrait. And I'm going to reroll a few times. Ah, that's the portrait. Just reroll a few times until we get some points that are good for our fighter. We want a lot of hit points, a lot of strength, a lot of constitution. Yeah, that looks good. We'll name him Terry. Second character. Let's choose a human female, also a fighter. I want two fighters up front. And let's choose a portrait, let's say, there, that one. And let's roll a few times and see if we can get some good stats. constitution is really low. Let's go with that. It's just a demonstration anyway. Call her Alia. And then we'll want a wizard, so I'm gonna choose an elf male. And I want him to be a mage. I'm just gonna go with chaotic good. Choose that one. See if we can get a lot of intelligence and charisma. Okay. Lolo. And the last one, I'm gonna use a human female. And she's gonna be a cleric, so we're gonna have access to healing spells. Lawful good. And it's the one that's praying is appropriate. And let's see. Yep, that looks good. Start. And she is Zara. So, we are ready. We can start the game. Game's loading. And here we go. We are at the entrance of the tunnel, which you can see has been blocked off by all these boulders. And I'll give you a quick overview of the user interface. You have these buttons here. Forward, backward, rotate 90 degrees, and then you can also strafe left and right. Here's our compass. Here's our four characters. We have our two fighters in the front, our mage and our cleric. If you click on a portrait, you can see the inventory here and the equipped weapons. With the arrows, you can switch to the other characters, and they all start with just a ration. And if you click on the character again, you go back here, and you can also just click on any other character. And that's the way how you access the inventory. Then there's a button here called camp. So the first thing we need to do is we need to camp so that we can have our spells memorized for Lolo, who was our mage. So I'm just going to go with offensive, so I'm just going to give him the level 1 spells, just the two that we have available as Shocking Grasp. And I wonder if we have... Yeah, we have one spell available, Melf's Acid Arrow at level 2. So I'll use that one. Then we will pray for spells for our Cleric Zara. So first level spells, let's use Cure Light Wounds. She has 3. And then second level spell, we have aid, slow poison, hold person. I'll just do aid. We have 1 slot available. And now, when we rest the party, those spells will be memorized, as you can see in the text output window here below. So I'm going to exit this and we're going to start our adventure. So I'm just going to rotate 90 degrees, and so we have this tunnel, and we're just going to go forward, which leads us into a large room. Now, it's very important that you look out for objects lying on the ground. For example, here, there is a skeleton. If I click on it, see, I have picked up some lockpicks, which I'm going to put in the inventory of Terry. And I've also got some bones, which I'm going to keep. And I'm also going to put in the inventory of Terry. And as you can see, there is this gate in front of us. Now, usually when there is a gate, there is a button nearby, and that button is here left. So if I click that button, the gate opens, and we can go through. Here's our first fight. So I'm just going to have my fighters use their swords. It's a bit early to start casting spells because these are quite easy adversaries or opponents. So that was that. Unfortunately, he didn't drop anything. Usually they drop a dagger or so at this level. I'm just gonna continue. And we have a choice, go left or straight. I'm just gonna go straight ahead and turn right. And there is another gate here. And there is a button right next to it, which opens it up. And now we can just continue. And we're just going to keep following. Following the path here. And we arrive at another gate. And there should be a switch nearby, as there usually is. Ah, yeah, there's one here in this alcove. There we go. So I'll just strafe. Ah, we have two more. Let's attack. I'm also gonna cast some spells at these guys. So you do this by just right-clicking the weapons that our characters have equipped, or clicking here on the spell. There's one down. I think we're out of, yeah, we're out of spells. So, there we go. They're all dead. So, what have they left behind? We have a dagger, which I could put in my inventory, but I'm just gonna put it straight into the hands, the second hand of our fighter. And here we have a... what is this? Scroll of Detect Magic. I'm gonna give that to our friend Lolo, who's our mage. And yeah, if all goes well, we can just continue. We might rest. That might be a good idea, because we have lost some hit points. And so I'm just gonna rest the party until we're healed. Sometimes this can take a while, depending on the amount of hit points. Okay, we're done. And now also our spells are all recharged, so we can cast spells again. So I'm just gonna continue forward. Now there is this pressure plate here. I'm standing on it right now. And basically if you stand on it, it locks the gate behind you. So we're now locked in here. Oh, there's an object lying here on the ground. Looks like we have a rock or... oh no, it's a ration. Okay, I'm just gonna keep those. Move forward. Grab the other ration. And I'm just gonna go in here. And we're just gonna keep going forward and then left, keep going. There is another portal or door, so I think there must be a button somewhere for it. I think I missed it. Yeah, I don't know where the button is, unfortunately, to open this, so let's just follow this tunnel here. And we have a switch here. And we have more goblins, four of them. So I'm gonna open my spells, cast Fortunately, those daggers that we pick up are such poor quality that they disintegrate after using them once. Here we go, we won the fight, and we have another dagger, and another dagger, and it looks like a third dagger, so I'll just put that into the inventory, and let's continue. Here, so we'll go this way. Now we can choose to go left or right. Let's go right. Oh, there's a pressure plate that opens this gate. So the trick is to stand in front of it, and those bones are quite heavy. So if we put those there, it will push on the pressure plate and allow us to go through. Yep, so now we're in past that door. Looks like we have something here. A rock. I'm just gonna put that rock into the inventory. Here. Yeah, it's a bit difficult for me to see the mouse because I'm at a high angle with the camera in front of the machine. And let's continue. Can we open that gate there? Yes, it's got a button on it. Let's see if this leads anywhere. Oh, a worm. Let's quickly attack. Got him. And another dagger. Okay. So anyway, this is the first of many levels of the sewers, and then later on it turns into a dungeon and then into a castle. I'm not gonna keep playing because this is basically the gameplay. You know, we don't want to review the whole game. We just want to see how well it runs on the Palmtop, how playable it is. And so we're gonna stop playing here, and I'm going to show you guys our new system that I've developed, the HP Palmtop game fitness score. So this is the HP Palmtop game fitness score table. I'm gonna be using this system from now on for all my Will It Play game reviews. It does not score the actual game, the quality of the game or the gameplay, but it just scores how usable and playable it is on an HP Palmtop. So let's start with graphics. I'm going to give this a full 3 out of 3 for visibility and LCD refresh. Everything is clearly visible. Everything is clearly readable. It's easy to spot even small objects lying on the ground and on the ground, and there is just no issue at all with any visibility. The game is not a scrolling game or a platformer, so the LCD refresh doesn't really matter. Then for the aspect ratio, I'm gonna give it a 1 out of 1. So this basically means that the change of aspect ratio from a 4:3 monitor to the Palmtop's 2 out of 5 aspect ratio squashes the game vertically, and in some games that might cause problems, but in this case it really doesn't matter. I mean, it plays very well, and the aspect ratio change doesn't have any impact at all for me. Sound wise, I'm giving it only a 1 out of 3 because all we can get is PC speaker sound. It would be nice if we could have ad-lib. That would give us a 2 out of 3, or an MT32. That would give us a full 3 out of 3. But unfortunately, this game appears to be very hard to patch, and we just haven't managed to patch it yet. So a 1 out of 3 for sound. Controls, I'm going to give it a full 3 out of 3. I mean, the game is fully playable via mouse. I'm not even using any of the keyboard shortcuts for casting spells quickly and such. I'd have to read the manual a little bit more to find out all those keys. But it's not really necessary. You can play the whole thing just with a mouse very comfortably. The mouse cursor is also very visible, and you don't lose track of it as you do on some games which have poorly visible mouse cursors on the black and white LCD of the Palmtop. So that goes for a total score of 8 out of 10 points, which ranks very good. So I would definitely recommend that you download or purchase this game if you haven't purchased it already, and play it on your Palmtop. It's a really good game to play on the Palmtop. I can play this for hours. You can download maps like this one, which will make your trip through the dungeons a lot easier. And I'm also going to put it on our ranked list of HP Palmtop games at number 2, right below SimCity, which remains my favorite game to play on the Palmtop. And hopefully, with more Will It Play reviews coming out, we're going to end up with a long ranked list of games, so people can see which games are the best to play on the Palmtop and can get hold of those to play for themselves. Thank you for watching.